Hello everyone, the lab experiment that we are going to discuss today is a star delta stator experiment. So in a three phase induction motor, we know that it is a self starting motor, but still there are a few reasons why we need a starter circuit that has to be externally connected to the motor for safe operation. Now there are different types of starters which are used in squirrel cage induction motor, like DOL starter, direct online starter, star delta starter and auto transformer starter. And in a slip ring induction motor, the starter circuit that is used is rotor resistance starter. So basically we use a starter circuit in order to restrict high starting current. The initial current when we provide the supply to the motor, the initial current is very very high. And in order to restrict that initial current, we use a stator circuit so that the windings can be protected. Windings of the motor can be protected. Now, there is also a provision that why we use the stator circuit is to protect the motor or the machine from overload conditions. When there is an overload due to any sort of power supply up down or any sort of fuse that takes place in the power circuit, power system, which is connected to the motor, many instruments and devices which are connected will get tripped. So, with the help of a particular starter circuit, whenever there is a overload, then the supply directly gets cut off from the motor circuit connection through a relay that is present. I will show you in the further slides. Now, these are the two reasons why a starter circuit is used. When we see a squirrel cage induction motor, there is a stator winding which has three phases and there is a squirrel cage rotor. This forms the machine circuit conditions. Now, when we use a starter circuit, this is the starter circuit that we will be implementing and this is the circuit diagram of the star delta starter. When the machine is initially starting, then in that time the motor connections will be in star, and then we will change after it reaches around 80% of the rated speed. We will change the connections of the stator windings of the motor into running mode, that is the delta connection. So if we take a star connection, let us say we connect it like this, A1, A2 terminals of a particular winding, then B1, B2 terminals of a particular winding, and C1, C2 terminals of a particular winding. These are the three windings, and in the star connection, A2, B2 and C2, these three terminals are shorted. A1, B1, C1 are connected to the supply. They're all connected to the supply. Now similarly, if we take a delta connection, we can name it as A1, A2, B1, B2, C1 and C2, such that A2 and C1 are shorted, B2 and A1 are shorted, B1 and C2 are shorted. We can see it in the machine itself. There will be terminals written as A1, B2, C1, sorry, B1, C2, C1 and A2. Six terminals will be there and their connections will be made like this. So that if you see in this particular diagram also, we can find that the shorted terminals are A2, B2, C2 and A2. So let's see how practically the operation of the particular star delta starter occurs. Because in a star delta starter, there is this TPDT switch, that is the triple pole double throw switch, which is operated with the help of a handle that helps in changing the status of the starter from a star connection to the delta connection. This occurs once around 75 to 80% of the rated speed is reached in the initial time. Once the 80% of a rated speed, usually the rated speed is 14,050. So usually the rated speed is 1450 RPM or else 1500 RPM. So once it reaches around 75 to 80% of that particular value, then we convert or we use the handle to operate the connections and change its position from star to delta connection, so that after delta connection is placed, the rest running condition goes on till we switch off the supply. Let us see how it happens. These are the A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2 are the terminals of the motor, stator of the motor. Now these are connected here. Actually, this is the star delta starter circuit. Here the supply terminals are connected. These supply terminals are connected to the contactor switches through a relay. This is a current time setting relay. This current is already set. Once the current goes above this particular setting, this relay trips and the supply gets disconnected from the contactor. Now these contactor is actually connected in these three forms. These are the three contactor connections which are connected to the supply. Now basically this is the off position. This is the off position of the star delta starter. In the bottom it is written A1, B2, B1, C2, C1, A2. These are the terminals which are connected to the supply, that is motor, that is the motor terminals connected above here. Now when we are changing the position of the position of this handle from star to delta, first we will connect in the star connection. This is the star connection. What happens here? The supply over here connected through this to the A1 terminal. The supply over here connected through this to the B1 terminal. The supply over here is connected through this to the C1 terminal. What about the rest three terminals, B2, C2 and A2? They are shorted with the help of a bimetallic strip which is present. Internally, these three terminals are shorted. These three terminals are shorted internally. Now, once we change the position from star to delta, this is the position change from star to delta connection. Now, what happens when we go to the bottom? A1 and B2 are shorted. B1 and C2 are shorted. C1 and A2 are shorted with this plate. On the top, supply comes from here to this one, and then all these two are shorted. From this is the Y connection, comes the supply, and these two terminals are shorted. From this comes the supply of the C, that is the blue, and these two are shorted. When this is the connection, that is in delta connection, it is observed that the speed goes up to 100%. But initially in the star connection actually helps in restricting the current. The starting current, which is very, very high in the star connection, is restricted. And then the speed, it is observed that when it reaches from 0 to around 75% to 80% of the rated speed, the position from star is changed to delta connection. In this way, this particular star delta starter helps in restricting the initial current, and thus it protects the motor from the excessive heating which is produced due to the initial starting current, which is very heavy. This is the OCB oil circuit breaker, which has ratings of 400 by 440 volts, 3 phases supply, 50 hertz is the frequency, 100 amperes. And when we are turning on, we are providing the supply here, and this line current is connected towards the starter circuit. This is the starter circuit. Now from the starter circuit, you can see the starter circuit is also running at 400 volts and 3 phases, 50 hertz supply. 3 ampere is the rated current.
Now when we turn it on, we have turned it on now. We will first of all place it in the star connection, and then once it reaches around 75 to 80% of its rated speed, we will then change its position to the delta connection. Now the bottom part is the star connection and the above part is the delta connection as already shown. So we'll turn on the motor now. See the current. The current value is around 2 to 3 ampere. In a star connection, the current, phase current is same as the line current, but in a delta connection, the phase voltage is equal to the line voltage. So when we observe the voltage in the delta connection, we find it is as 440 volts, just as the supply voltage. Phase voltage is equal to the line voltage. And as we observed in the star connection, when the motor was running in the star connected starter, at that time the phase current was equal to the line current, which was almost equal to 3 amperes. So thus we conclude that we can protect the motor from overloads using a starter circuit. We can limit the heavy current, heavy initial current, from destroying the windings of the motor by using the help of star delta starter. Thank you.